Good evening, everyone. This is an amazing moment. I think this is a quintessential New York City moment. My wife, Shirley, and I were watching, and this is sort of everything good about New York City in one place, in one event. And I'm going to be very quick. First, it's just good to remember all the people who made things happen, and our wonderful council member, Rosie Mendez, and Community Board 3, and the Department of Cultural Affairs, everyone who made this happen. I have to say to Mia and to my dear friend Frank Carucci that you guys have kept the flame burning of an amazing artistic and community vision. And I think it's equally important to say it's an artistic vision, but it's also a vision of community that typified Ellen Stewart and her contributions to New York City. And Frank in particular, for years, I have to say I've known your work as an activist, half artist. It's a powerful combination. So thank you for all you have done. And just one other thing I want to say about this place. Every one of us has been touched by La Mama in so many ways, and for some of us, it's people we knew who were changed so deeply by the experience of La Mama. I happen to have a wonderful friendship with the actor Steve Buscemi, who's now at Boardwalk Empire and is a great activist in his own right. Part of who he is came from here, and we could list so many others like him who were shaped by this extraordinary place. And that's why we have to honor it. Finally, that Ellen Stewart, I think it's fair to say that history has not yet caught up with Ellen Stewart and all she did for the arts and for New York City. I don't think it'll be understood for a while. And she will get her due more and more over time. The one thing I think we can say is that New York City has this extraordinary tradition of changing the world and sort of amazingly deep and profound ways in public life. You know, the New Deal came from New York City, and so much of what happened from the 60s came from New York City, and apparently there's something happening down by Wall Street now that's having an effect all over the world. So New York City does that. In the arts, you could name 1,000 examples, but Ellen Stewart's is so profound. And so we're here today to remember. It's not just what she did, we should remember her always, but that she was the best and really exemplified the best of New York's ability to shape the world and make it a place of much greater insight, much greater understanding, much greater possibility. Thank you very much.
Let me introduce to you somebody who is on a BlackBerry right now. Oh, iPhone. Oh, me too. Okay. No wonder we see eye to eye. Or iPhone to iPhone. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome a woman who is one of the best, and we are lucky to have her here representing the Lower East Side, you know, the East Village. Let us give it up for a wonderful City Council member, none other than Rosie Mendez!
Good evening. How are we doing today? Now, doesn't Kamalita look excellent? Did you check out that outfit? Get up. Look at this. Wow. So I'm going to say one extra thing. Bill de Blasio said everything that's wonderful about New York City all happening in one place. Well, it's always happening in my district, and I feel so privileged to represent this incredible, diverse district. Through the years, before I've been in office now 6 years, and what you see happening here on this block was the vision of a couple of people, Ellen Stewart, many of the other theater companies here, and my predecessor, Margarita Lopez. And the vision was to renovate all of these theater companies, the theaters from inside, to make this a cultural district. This is the only cultural, designated cultural district in Manhattan, and it's right here on this block. And since Margarita taught me well for the last 6 years, I've been trying to bring the capital dollar. members, and I've had help from my speaker, Christine Quinn, and from the borough president. We've been putting money in all our theater companies here so that we can make this a thriving block. And the one thing about the bells, you know why you got bells, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, why?
To ring them.
Okay, I think I heard it and all that. But Ellen used to ring a bell at the beginning of every performance. So, but also, as I was sitting here listening to all the bells, it reminded me of one of my favorite movies, It's a Wonderful, Wonderful Life. And when an angel gets its wings.
Coming down.
So, not only does Ellen get her wings, she gets her street name today right on the corner. Thank you, everyone.
Ellen would be so happy and so proud, and as we all are, I don't know, I get little goose pimples, you know, because I see street bridges over there, they're going to be, you know, tomorrow night, and see, I just, you know, love it all, and feel very proud to be here, and she's looking right now, and she's saying, who's next? Well, it's Susan Setzker from Manhattan Community Board 3, and she is the district manager. Give it up for Susan.
Hi, thank you. I'm just getting over laryngitis, so I won't have my usual big mouth today. Community Board 3 is very proud to support and participate in the street co-naming. It's fitting in every way because this block is very special. It is the only, as Rosie said, the only official cultural district in the city. And our community is very special, a progressive community that honors our artists. Ellen Stewart was an extraordinary person. She broke barriers and took risks, and she made La Mama and this block a cultural destination for people from all over the world. She made La Mama an incubator for innovative artists, and she helped launch careers. This block is unique, and it's important because it is a diverse block that brings together as a family, theaters, other cultural institutions, people who live in affordable housing and not so affordable housing, and our nonprofits and the community board, all to serve the community. And we're all very proud to be living and working on Ellen Stewart Way. Thank you.
Susan, muchas gracias. Muchas gracias, because we speak every language there is. And now it is my privilege. My privilege because, you know, sometimes the bell gets passed on. And when you pass on a bell, you have to pass it on to the right woman. The right woman. And we are very fortunate that the right woman has got a bell. And give it up for the none other than the beautiful Mia.
Community here on 4th Street. Ellen loved this block, and we thank you so much for all the love and support you gave back to us over these 5 decades. This block has always been our home, but we've always also been really deeply connected to a world community that we've been connected through our international network of artists and groups. And so, As Rosie said, Ellen had a ritual of ringing the bell before she announced the show to gather the audience, and our world family has sent their birthday greetings to us to basically say happy birthday and to give us good wishes.